morning, students. I am here with another chapter of parts of a speech, that is pronoun. All you know, there are so many types of pronoun, as I have discussed yesterday, that when we shall discuss the chapter pronoun, I will have to define so many things. I have to describe so many things in this chapter. Personal pronoun, first of all, I have to know that what is pronoun. There are two types of pronoun, subject pronoun and object pronoun. What is subject pronoun? The word which used as the subject of the sentence is called subject pronoun. Suppose, Sita is a good girl. She reads in class 9. She, that is, stands for Sita, is subject pronoun. This is the book she used to read in her class. Here, her is the object pronoun because her has come forward. This is the book which she read in her class. Subject pronoun which refers for the subject and object pronoun which refers for the object. Now we shall start one by one. How many types of pronoun are there? Personal pronoun stands for three persons. As you know, three persons are first person, second person and third person. For first person, I singular, we plural. Second person, you singular and yours plural. Third person, he, she, it singular and they plural. Personal pronouns stands for the three persons, that is first person, I singular and we for plural. Second person, you and yours. Third person, he, she, it and they. Now, it's time for possessive pronouns. What is possessive pronoun? Add the word. Defines itself, possessive. Possessive, that means the things which I possess. Suppose, this is my book. My. Whose book is this? My. So, it shows possession. Whose things it belongs to. Next, reflexive pronoun. What is reflexive pronoun? Same person. Subject of a verb. That I, suppose I am the subject of the verb. I will say that I will do this work myself. I, personal pronoun, subjective pronoun, and do my work myself. Myself is reflexive pronoun. Myself is reflexive pronoun. You will play football yourself. You is second person, singular, personal pronoun, and yourself is reflexive pronoun. It stands for same persons of subject as verb. Emphatic pronouns. What is emphatic pronoun? For the sake of emphasis, the word we use to, for the sake of emphasis, we can say reflexive also, that I do this work myself. He himself will say what he has to say. He himself will say. I describe it in my own town itself. Then itself, himself, these are called emphatic pronouns. Our reflexive pronoun for the sake of emphasis on the subject. Demonstrative pronoun. What is demonstrative pronoun? As the word describes itself, it points out some things. Maybe it near or maybe it far. That this is the table. This table. Put your book on that table. Maybe this thing may be near or maybe far from me. Suppose I have to say that this is my pen. That is my board. This is me. That is he. So these things are called demonstrative pronouns. Point out the object to which they refer. Indefinite pronouns. As the word describes itself, indefinite. It is not sure. Some people, few people, many, all, one and none. These are not, someone has done this. But I am not sure who has done this. Many of you used to say so. Many of you, but not sure who is this many. So, indefinite pronouns always refers that someone whom I don't know definitely. Interrogative pronouns at the word explain itself. Interrogative, that means questions. It arises some questions. Always introduce a question. Who, which, what? Do you know who has done this? Do you know who has done this? Here, who is interrogative pronoun? Which book is this? This is interrogative pronoun. What have you told me yesterday? What is interrogative pronoun? What you told me yesterday is not true. What you are going to say is not clear to me. Here, what, which, who, the what you told about him yesterday, I don't know who is he. So these words, who, which, what, are interrogative pronouns. Now, relative pronoun. What is relative pronoun? Join two sentences. Suppose, this is the book which I wanted to know. This is the book for which I was searching. I come to know about this, but who has told this to you? Whom this pen belongs? These things are called relative pronouns, which joins two sentences. What I told you yesterday is not sure. What I told you yesterday is not correct. What I told you yesterday is not going to be. What I told you yesterday is just my guess. I'm not sure of it. So relative pronouns joins two sentences in this way. Before going for the examples of correct and incorrect sentences, I'm going to summarize the chapter once again. Relative pronouns join two sentences. I have discussed earlier. There are two types. Always keep in mind that there are two types of pronouns. Subjective pronoun and object pronoun. Subject, which stands for the subject. Object, which stands for the object. As, this book is mine. This is a book. It is mine. This subject and it is mine. It stands for the book. This is object. So, subjective pronoun. I am sure you have understood what is subjective pronoun and what is objective pronoun. This is my book. This book is new. This is my book. This stands for subject and it is a new book. It stands for the book, this book. So it is object of the sentence. Is it clear? Now, I conclude this video with some examples as I used to do every day. Ravi and me are going to the library. Ravi and I are going to the library. These are the silly mistakes you have to keep in your mind. Who is at the door? It's me. Who is at the door? Not it's me. It's I. I and my friends play cricket. This is a wrong sentence. Keep in mind. You have to say, my friends and I play cricket. Next one is, everyone must do their own work. This is a wrong sentence. Keep in mind. You have to say, everyone must do his or her work. Because everyone is a singular. And so, its possessive pronoun should be his or her, which is singular. Or you may say, all must do their own work. All is a plural pronoun, so there should be plural possessive pronoun. Next one, he himself did the work. He did the work himself. Anu invited Sasi and I to her party. This is a wrong sentence. You have to say, Anu invited Sasi and me to her party. Each group will present their project to the class. Each group will present its project to class. Same thing is here. Each, that stands for singular pronoun. And so, it's the possessive pronoun should be singular also. So, each group will present its project to the class, not their project. Because each is singular and there is plural. So, I have to match the possessive pronouns and the subjective pronouns. And you have to keep in this mind. Always remember, these small things becomes a big mistake for tomorrow. So, to escape, to be very correct, very to the point, you have to keep in mind all these things on this. Don't underestimate that these are the very small chapters. These are for the KG students. These are for the junior students. No, I have my own experience that the stage where the grammar ends, the class 12, where we have not to study formal grammar. But I find students, most of the students misunderstood these things, and at that stage, they hesitate to ask clearly and they can't understand themselves, and this is the reason they make themselves aloof from the language and face so many difficulties in competitive exams, because competitive exam is not a very rocket science and there are so many difficult. No, this is the simple things which we fail to comprehend clearly in our initial stage, and it becomes a big blunder in our future. So never underestimate these things. The very initial things are very compulsory things, and if you make such silly mistakes, then it will definitely put a question mark before your career. So keep it up and do the works minutely. I have given the screenshot in the middle of the video for your detailed consideration of the chapter, and next day we shall continue the same with another topic of parts of a speech. Till then, enjoy your day.